Good evening, YouTube. Welcome back to Play the Hits. This is Chrono Trigger, and with you again is Chris Beck.
And this is Max, back again.
How you doing tonight, Max?
Pretty good.
Other than your kind of shitty internet connection?
Yeah, well, I have a feeling we'll survive this. Oh.
Which reminds me, there's our safety save, just in case.
Yeah, it's not like I need this game at 1080p, so we're fine. Now, hold on. Okay, so giving the Mass Immune to Frog.
That's where we left off.
And then what? Is it straight to Magus's place?
Yeah, we dive right into Magus.
Okay. All right, sweet. So, how's it been going with you? It's been about 6 days, I think. 7 days, maybe. It's been a week since the last time we recorded.
Yeah, I think it's been a week on the dot, and things have been going good. Still playing catch-up at work from vacation, but yeah, not bad.
Oh, yeah. That's you come back from vacation, or at least for me, I'm useless for at least a day. It's just like, how do you work again? Right. Why do I have to?
That's what you get.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like a good deal. Seems kind of bogus, but...
This lone tadpole here has some guts.
Right.
Oh, that's right. They counter every single time you hit them, though, which is really annoying. Son of a bitch.
He's pretty hardy for a tadpole, too.
Yeah, that's exactly right. He's got a fair amount of HP. Jackass. There's our kill. Well, Luca, I hope you've enjoyed your last moments being in my team.
I was about to say, like, Frog has to come with you, so.
Well, not only that, though, but Frog is pretty much like a permanent fixture in my party after he joins.
Oh, yeah. And it's like, you're not going to get rid of Marley.
No, at least not until Magus joins up.
Poor Luca, she's best girl, but I get it. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sexist in this game, or rather I feel like I'm forced to be, because, I mean, Frog and Magus are just unstoppable.
Yeah.
Frog gets some really good double techs with Chrono, and then Magus's magic is just
Magus is just Magus. Like...
Yeah, you can't answer him. You know, for as important as Cyrus is, I love that he's just a retexture of the Knight Commander.
Well, there's other forms of him, right?
Yeah, that's right. I think you see him once when he's younger, yeah.
Okay.
Sir Cyrus, on behalf of the knighthood, we wish you safe journey and godspeed.
Don't die like a chump is what we're saying. Don't pull a Boba Fett on us.
Oh, snap.
And then, yeah, they reveal the Frog was just like the skinny loser who followed the hero. Though I really like Frog's story. Like, I love his, like, evolution from kind of this, like, wimpy character to this noble knight.
Yeah, he's very much like the sidekick, and I like how they kind of show his history, and then you see him basically come into it, basically when he, like, fucking splits the mountain.
Oh, yeah.
This guy's a badass.
I kind of feel like, in retrospect, Cloud borrows a lot of his character arc from Glenn.
Sort of, yeah. He just really looks up to this, you know, very strong figure, and then kind of really comes into his own.
Yep, then watches him die, basically loses himself because of the villain, and then redeems himself when he takes the villain down. I mean, that's... Yeah.
Ozzy.
Fucking Ozzy, yeah.
Why is he so funny?
They aren't really clear with how long ago this was either. I mean, I assume it was a few years. But, like, people in the castle talk like Cyrus left for his mission yesterday.
What's with this random rainbow just... chilling right there.
Yeah, I know. It's implied that it's kind of a cloudy day, isn't it?
I mean, it kind of looks a little gray right now. And just
yeah, it's a little overpronounced. I see what you're saying. Fucking Magus. So, hey, speaking of Boba Fett, and I know this is a jump, but have you seen Solo yet?
No, I haven't. And
oh, shit. I was hoping to discuss that.
Oh, shit. Yeah. I don't even know if it's in theaters still, but I've been wanting
to. I think
it
is. I think you might have like another week with it. You should definitely check it out if you get a chance.
Seriously, it's that and Deadpool 2 that I need to be seeing.
Yeah, Deadpool 2 I'll probably end up getting on Blu-ray. I think I missed that one.
Okay. Yeah.
But definitely see it if you get a chance.
I have Fandango credit. I got freaking... I got these two free movie tickets that there was like a little I won in a little terrarium contest back in I think December. Yeah, I could see a couple movies and I don't have to pay anything.
Nice, dude. Actually, you should just fucking make a weekend trip down here to Bloomington and we can go see it together.
Okay. We're actually I think Addie might have been talking about that with Sarah. I'm not sure. We were trying to see maybe if there was a time before child number two that we could come down or come visit.
That'd be tight, man.
Yeah,
make it happen.
Well, I actually so you know we're going through Sailor Moon and
that's right,
we made reservations for I think they're doing like a Fandango event for Sailor Moon R the movie and Sailor Moon Super S.
Oh, tight.
And so we had tickets and then we realized like about a week later it's like, oh wait a second, that's we got something else going on that day. We have a what do you call it, my sister-in-law is having a baby shower for Henry for their kid.
Oh wow.
Yeah, which I mean of course we're gonna be there, so it's not a big deal. I think we're gonna probably go see Sailor Moon Super S the next weekend after.
Well, at least you're doing something productive with that time.
Yeah.
I'm going to hell. Okay, so let's see here. I don't think I have any area of effect attacks, so let's do it this way. Take these suckers out.
It's like such a useful move right there.
Yeah, it's pretty well unstoppable. At least for this point in the game.
Yeah.
Fuck that frog. So, are you picking up Octopath Traveler this week?
Not this week. I don't know when I'm going to pick it up. I played, like, I don't know, did you end up playing the demo?
No, you know, I keep forgetting that demo exists.
Yeah,
but that's okay, because I played the first one. Oh, wow. I did play the first one, and I don't mind going in pretty fresh.
Okay, so. Okay, yeah. I mean, the game itself is a lot of fun. The battle system does remind me of Bravely Default a little bit. It's and it goes at a pretty good, you know, it clicks along pretty well, you know.
Cool.
So I've only played like the Scholar's Path so far, but it is fun.
Nice.
The only thing that gets me is kind of the audio stuff, and I'm not sure if you're gonna be able to change it to Japanese. I don't think.
I heard that you are able to.
Yeah, I was just thinking, I was like, because I want the story in English, but I want like the battle stuff in Japanese, and you can't do it that way. It's like, that's fine. That's okay. Another thing is you can't turn off, if you turn off voices, it's like all off, basically. You know.
Oh, really?
And I want the story, like the full-on cutscenes, I want the voices there, but in the typical, you know, map dialogue and stuff, and when you're in town, when it's not really an important scene, they still do like little bits of dialogue that just annoy the piss out of me for whatever reason. I can't get over it. I think I complained about that last time where it's
you
just
did.
Like, can you get that book for me? And it's like, excuse me, could you? And it's just like, why? I don't know. It gets me. So, but that's okay. That's a small gripe. I feel like it's gonna be a really good RPG, and I'm hoping the first reviews are going to be coming out any day now. So.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, so it'll be a good one. I kind of feel like, as far as least in the RPG category, that'll be a contender for, you know, RPG of the year. I'm trying to think. I mean, what else?
I'm pretty much dead set. I'm really going to enjoy Octopath, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to give that one to Dragon Quest XI.
I was about to say, Dragon Quest is the only other thing. That's, what, October?
No, November? September.
September.
It comes
okay.
out within, like, 3 days of Spider-Man. So I think my strategy is going to be to pick Spider-Man up first yeah. and play the hell out of that, because I assume that will be the shorter of the two games.
I feel okay, it's Dragon Quest. Yeah, it's definitely going to be the shorter of the two games.
Yeah, and then get really into Dragon Quest. not because I'm looking forward to Spider-Man more necessarily. Like, I've had both of them on my radar ever since they were announced.
Yeah.
But just, I think Dragon Quest is going to be the lengthier project, so I think I'm going to get my fill of Spider-Man first.
Yeah. And I was just thinking, like, as far as RPGs go, like, what else is there for, like, coming up?
That's a good question.
There was, I think it was this year, Ni no Kuni 2 was, like, the beginning of this year, right? And I haven't played it.
Did you ever play through the first one?
No. We only got a few hours in. You know,
oh, okay.
It was all right. It wasn't, like, fantastic. You know, it didn't really get our attention, but it was cute.
Yeah.
So, did you pick that one?
Yeah, no, I actually picked it up for you, because I figured it was a Ghibli game, and I figured, yeah, I know, right? All these great games I buy you, and you just don't get into them.
I know. I'm still going to get into Persona, trust me. I really enjoyed the first few hours of that game. I found nothing wrong with it, and I'm not even, like, touching the story yet. It's just, I'm into Nier right now, and I'm finishing up some other stuff.
Yeah.
But I think I've totally conquered Mario Odyssey at this point. We just got 999 moons yesterday, so.
Dude, you know what would be super ambitious? I mean, your birthday's coming up. Maybe, say, someone got you an Elgato. What if we were to, like, stream Persona 5 start to back your playthrough?
We could do that.
That would be super. That would probably be, like, over a year, like FF7.
Oh my god, that would be for sure. And if I'm just, like, going through the story straight up, I'm sure it'd still be at least as long.
Well, that's the thing. The game doesn't really let you just go through the story. Like, if you don't do the side stuff, you end up woefully unprepared for dungeons.
Wow.
That's why the game... I mean, I got more invested into the side stuff than I think I did the main story. But still, I mean... From start to finish, that game took me about 125
Holy
hours.
Crap. I don't know if you can still hear me, but...
Yeah, I can hear you.
I'm just listening to you probably from 20 seconds ago, and it's going really slow. So I'm just waiting for the connection to catch up, basically.
That's awesome. I don't know if you're getting this right now, but if you are, I am getting a kick out of it. If you need to disconnect and reconnect... just go for it. Yeah. I should still be hosting the call.
Okay, good. Sweet. It totally shitted out there for a second, but I think we're good now. Now, yep.
Oh boy, just in time for this badass cutscene.
I am getting video, and it's like, I don't want to miss this. Oh, whoa.
This is tight. Not,
yeah, and this, I'm... Okay, I want to see this. Okay, we're back.
Fuck yeah, Frog. I know, I love it so much.
That's awesome.
Like, I actually forgot what I was talking about because this cutscene is so badass.
How many cutscenes does the PlayStation version have? I know it has a few.
It's got a few more. Because
I never played, I only played very little of the, okay, so it doesn't cut out anything from the game itself. It just kind of adds it before.
Right, you still see the full 16-bit version, which is cool.
Okay, that's good. I don't want it to actually cut out anything. This
reminds
me of a certain limit break from Final Fantasy VIII.
Yeah, right. What was that called? Not Rough Divide, but...
The one right after Rough Divide.
Oh, yeah, the one where Squall literally does the exact same thing. Blasting Zone.
Oh, yeah. Okay, let's do that in every battle.
Right. Which, actually, in FF8 is an option.
Yeah, it's not like... Yeah, that FF8 was a game you could really just cheat if you want. If you knew the intricacies of the game, which I didn't as a kid. It was fun figuring that out later.
Yep.
And just basically keeping people on limits all the time, which was fun.
Yep. Dude, FF18 was the easiest game in the series to break.
08?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you were willing to spend a little time, like, getting your hands dirty with Triple Triad, which, by the way, is really fun. It's a really fun game.
And, I enjoy it.
And if you wanted to, like, run away from battles, basically, and keep your level low while boosting your stats with magic and cards and stuff like that.
Right.
Yeah, you could break that game pretty easily.
Dude, I just realized we totally have to take a quick detour back to the end of time. Yep, okay.
Oh.
And teach Frog some magic.
Okay. I felt like there was a side quest or something we were missing. I guess that's what it is.
I like how the game actually tells you that.
That's cool, yeah.
Convenient.
Go visit, our friend Specchio.
Yeah.
Who I wonder if he's still a white ape.
Yeah, I don't know what he's going to be. He's probably going to kick my ass still, but at least I'll get Frog's magic. No need to bother with these chumps.
Yeah, the water spells.
Yeah. And actually, he gets some really good double and triple techs with Marlee. Like, their ice water one is actually really high damage.
Yeah, so, I'm still playing through Nier. I haven't gotten too much farther, but...
Yeah,
still enjoying that one. And I'm just about done with the DLC on Zelda, I think.
Oh, cool.
Did you end up doing the,
No, I'm a lazy piece of crap. I have not done any of the Breath of the Wild DLC.
Okay. Well, that one, I knew there was some story. I don't know if there's a whole lot, but there was something in there that surprised me that I'm at right now. So I'm kind of near the end of it, and he's still this.
Ah, interesting. So, a weird surprise for a Zelda game, huh?
Yeah.
That's okay, pretty cool.
Walk around the fucking room three times.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm glad it doesn't make you do that again. Yeah, what the hell? Let's see if we can take him out now. My guess is he's still going to kick my ass, but... Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, he's pretty tough.
Get him, Frog. That is the slowest animation in this game, I think. I know the stakes for this battle are next to nothing, but I'm still, like, kind of intense about it because I think I might be able to win.
Yeah. Does he give you anything for winning? Or is it just like, yeah, good job?
Damn it, Frog. The Frog's second heal spell actually ends up being halfway decent.
Does it?
Yeah, it heals everybody for, like, mid-level, which at the end of the game is really all you need. Oh, shit. Maybe he'll hit Chrono again. Frog just keeps licking him. You can stop now.
You can stop that.
You know what, Frog? I'm good. I'm good, buddy. Hey, I did win.
Wow.
Sweet. Oh, nice. And I just learned two...
Dual attacks.
Yeah.
That was embarrassing.
Guess you ain't so bad after all. Nice, okay. That's why it's worth fighting him in every form. You get some capsules. And you get the great music.
Right now, damn it.
Yeah. Sorry. Okay. Now, back to the real fight. So, about how far roughly do you think you are through Nier?
Well, I heard altogether it's around, depending on the side quest, 20 to close to 30 hours.
Okay.
So, and I'm like 13 hours in.
So, okay, so yeah, about halfway.
Halfway, yeah. And I'm doing some side quests, so yeah, I'm probably about halfway.
Nice.
Yeah. And, you know, some big story stuff has happened, so it's like, okay. Cool.
Sweet.
But yeah, as far as RPGs, I think it's pretty much not anything huge this year. And not even anything as far as like open, well, Let's see, what do we get? Because Fallout's not going to be a RPG.
Yeah, I'm not even going to bother with that Fallout.
Yeah.
I'm just not... Well, it's not even that I'm against MMO games. It's that, I don't have the time to dedicate to them. And then, two, after FF14, I mean, I don't know how anything could equal that.
It's like, if you're gonna have an MMO in your life, it's probably gonna be just one.
Yeah.
Unless, you know, you have all the free time in the world and
for
me,
play?
Like, 14 right. is... They're still updating that game, so...
Right. And for me, like, if I ever pick up another MMO, I'll probably just get back into 14.
Yeah. You already have a character established, or, like, two or three or something, right?
And no, I just have the one, but he's really well-developed. Or he was really well-developed. This was, like, pre all the DLC, so...
Yeah, and just from what you showed me, it's just, like, that game already started out huge.
Yeah, oh, and it was... Like, even if it were a single-player Final Fantasy, I still would have enjoyed how well that world was fleshed out and developed. Like, it was really well done.
Yeah, you know, and an MMO, it's like, okay, you can't compare the story itself to a mainline game because and that's not going to be there. It's not what it's about.
You know,
it's about the community and kind of being lost in the world itself. Mm-hmm. And that it did such a good job.
It did. Like, and that being said, they actually did manage to do a halfway decent story, too, which really surprised me.
Yeah.
Ah, shit. But the best part by far was just the world. I loved exploring Eos.
Yeah. And it's huge.
And bigger
than any of the... And it's not like it's undetailed at all.
No,
you know, it had a lot more detail than 15, I would say. Like
it did, yeah. I mean, 15, we've talked about that before. That was kind of that game's big weakness, is the world was sadly a little underdeveloped.
Yeah, bigger, but empty, you know.
Well, that's the thing. I don't even know if it's bigger, necessarily.
Yeah,
true. 14 is segmented, but when you take it all together, it is a very large world.
Yeah, and you really have to take every room, every part, you know, because you can't drive through huge expanses, you know, like 15.
Right.
But at the same time, you're not really looking through most of 15, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And in this game, the towns are just, there's so much to see.
Right.
And there's so much, you know, so many places you can go, so much to do. So.
And because it's an MMO, every single nook and cranny has a quest or... something that's interactable. So I mean they're very different beasts, and I enjoyed them both a lot. But 14, I mean, it wasn't just good for an MMO, it was a damn good game. I love this scene too.
How long has that bat been following you? Because I remember that's
yeah, that's gonna be Flea.
One of the Flea, okay. Yeah,
yeah.
I was like, that's number three. That's not Ozzy.
Yeah.
This part's pretty creepy.
It is, yeah.
I wish I could hear the music. I remember it's...
really makes an imposing
this
presence.
This part's really fucking creepy.
Yeah. So let's see here. We have our safety save, so I'll save here.
You got two saves, okay.
Yep, just in case. You know, and we should have been doing that all along. That's just a good practice to do, is to keep
the safety save. We've been bitten by that before.
That we have, when we lost that episode of FF7, as I remember.
Which is the best episode ever, and no one will ever know.
Right. Yeah, actually, that was a good lost episode. But some good came out of it, because that's ultimately what convinced me to buy the Elgato.
The Elgato. Yeah, that's true.
and really, actually, before that was even before I got my gaming PC, so it really convinced me to do the whole upgrade. This is our treasure. Okay. Yeah, they really make this castle creepy.
Yeah.
You know, in that 16-bit creepy
way. Then you see, all your family and stuff.
Right. As creepy as they can make this game. Frog, you're safe. Frog, you're safe.
I was like, wait, isn't that your mom?
Yeah, right. It's like, why is Frog, your mom safe. Talking shit? Okay, I think I have to explore both corridors before the castle proper starts.
I just remember you... This is long. This is a
Yeah, it's
long,
not a short dungeon.
Segment.
Yeah.
But you've gained, like, 5 levels here.
Yeah, we'll probably... end the episode with the Magus fight, I'm guessing. I don't think we're going to get any further than this in this one. Tight. I can't wait to get that sword. Let's see here. Let's play. Let's play. Yoink. Here we go. Oh boy. Creepsville. They kind of use that faux Kefka laugh.
Fucking Ozzy.
This is not a good week for Ozzy's or Oz's. I don't know if you've been watching my Batman playthrough, but no. Oswald Cobblepot is really starting to piss me off. You know, I'm basically... What's that?
How far are you in that?
I just finished chapter 3, so I'm just over the halfway point of the game.
Okay.
But yeah, it's really picking up the story. Yeah, I know. The story's getting really intriguing. So you should definitely give that a watch if you haven't.
Okay.
And yeah, basically I'm just going to keep using that spell for this dungeon. It just makes the fight so much simpler.
Yeah.
Ah, the sacrifice has arrived. Right on time, good chap.
I remember these things like transforming and saying really ugly shit to you.
Really? I don't think these ones transform. Maybe you're thinking of the bridge monster?
Maybe.
Well, it did zero to that guy.
Yeah, what the hell?
That's alright, Chrono's got him. Nice.
There we go.
That was a well-timed critical. Wow, that was not worth the 70 EXP for this point in the game. I don't think it's very good. Yeah. No, that was terrible.
Not really. It's the skeletons. I don't think they give you heart like anything. I think these are the same skeletons you fought like at the freaking prison.
I think you're right. I think it's just the big dude that's different.
These things with Marl and
I think you're right. I think that's the way to do it. Attaboy frog.
But, all
right. Yep, you're right.
There we go, yeah.
no need to waste my MP on these chumps.
You guys are garbage.
Human garbage.
You should have stayed dead.
You're garbage. Human garbage.
Human garbage.
What was that from?
That's Bob Barker from Bob Barker's Head.
That's right.
Drama.
Human garbage.
Garbage.
Oh man, what else was Bob Barker on that was so... Happy Gilmore.
It was Happy Gilmore. Yeah
Oh my god, that was probably the best like cameo. Yeah, like ever. Like to this day I cannot watch that scene without almost pissing my pants.
Me either.
Chrono's speed maxes out fairly early, so I don't know if I want to waste the speed capsule on him. I'm gonna give it to Marl just to get faster heals.
Well, at the end of the game, is it basically going to be Chrono, Frog, and Magus for you?
It is.
Okay.
And the only reason I just boosted Frog's magic is just so that his heals are a little more effective.
But aside from that, like, Marley's going to be in your party, like, for most of the game, though. I imagine. Right. I imagine. And then when Chrono's not in your party for some reason later on... I'm thinking...
Spoilers, yeah. Max. Come on. I love spoiling 20-year-old games.
Oh, yeah.
Sure,
everyone
watching
this is... Yeah, this we're is good. A fresh thing. It's like, should I get into this Chrono Trigger? Let's see how these fair chaps think of it.
Right. You know, dawns on me though that if we ever do, I was discussing this a little bit with Nick the other day, if we ever do like pick up an actual audience on YouTube, there's a good chance that the demographic watching this game may not have played these older SNES titles, and so this would be brand new for them.
That's true.
Like, well,
and I guess to them I say I'm sorry. Like,
yeah, right.
This is your foray into Chrono Trigger.
Yeah, right. It's your fault for being born in 2008. What the hell's wrong with you? Seems you freed my undying slaves. Oh boy. Oh, there's Slash. Cool. It has been ages, Slash. Let's Let's see, how am I? Yeah, we're good. We're gonna be just fine. We've got Aura Whirl and X-Strike. Oh boy.
Seems like he has that, stereotypical, like, Dragon Ball kind of racist look, Mr. Popo.
Yeah,
look.
A little bit. I was just thinking that same thing. Are his lips okay? Like, is that a thing you can show on YouTube these days? Okay, so keep in mind, that did 249. I want to see how much X-Strike does.
X-Strike is life. Just abused.
Oh, wow,
oh my
yeah.
God, yeah.
Not even a contest. I'm just going to keep Marl in the background for heals.
Healing once in a while, and then,
yep.
Yeah, just keep on X-Striking. So you kill everything.
Jab,
place.
Lunge, thrust! How are you doing? Actually, Marlee could use a heal. So could Frog. But that's why we're playing it this way.
Mm-hmm. Did you, did I ask you this? Have you played God of War yet?
No, I haven't played God of War, strangely enough. Okay.
I was wondering, that is kind of strange. I feel like the big AAA games, you're kind of on the up, well, the ones that interest you.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God of War would be there. But I know there's been just projects.
Yeah, and I mean, I'm not against God of War. I've actually had a lot of fun with the ones that I have played, but it's never been like a, you know, must-have day one purchase kind of game for me.
Okay. I'm hearing just from a narrative standpoint, it's like an excellent game.
Yeah.
You know, I've
it's supposed to be really good.
Any of the games. Well, I played a little bit of 3. But not too much. And,
yeah,
you know, it was fun enough. You know, it's the gameplay definitely kept me interested for a little while.
Yeah, I hear it brings an unusual sense of depth for that series.
That was quick.
Yeah, but he has
oh,
two forms.
Wait, he gets a sword. That's right.
Yeah, now he actually starts hurting me. You've no hope.
I love that trope in games. It's like, now that I'm halfway dead,
right.
I suppose I should get serious.
I better start trying. Oh shit. Yeah, we're gonna be fine.
Honestly, like, yeah, still not as hard as, like, the Masa and Mune fight.
Right. Let's see here.
I
should be okay to attack.
I think I want to pick that one up. I've heard, like, really good things. So, it's... And, you know, I got... Basically, as far as, like, the big projects I'm working on, it's Nier and Persona now.
Right.
Zelda, I think I'm going to be done very soon. Mario, we've been done pretty much for a while. It's just...
Dude, you got over a year of playtime out of Zelda. I think you've...
Seriously.
Yeah, got your money's worth there.
I totally have. That's... been great.
Yeah, Breath of the Wild was a damn good game, and I have my fair share of criticisms about it, but overall, I really had fun with it.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, definitely not my favorite Zelda, but far from my least favorite.
Not my favorite Zelda, but such a different open world experience.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if it's my best open world experience, but it's possible that it is. It's different from The Witcher 3, for sure.
I was just going to say, I still have to give that to The Witcher, unfortunately.
Yeah, the Witcher had, like, such a rich and interesting world, but when it came to sheer joy of seeing what's around the corner, just from the world itself,
yeah,
I'd give it to Zelda, you know, where it's like the world is more of a living, breathing thing.
I think a lot of people would agree with you on that, but I'm actually of the mind that The Witcher still had a far more interesting world in my perspective. Like, I really enjoyed kind of the darker atmosphere. I enjoyed, like, how living and breathing it felt like. Zelda did a really unique thing, which is that it was an engaging and interesting world, but you felt totally isolated. Like,
yeah.
you could tell that, like, something big had gone down here.
That's true.
Yeah. But with Witcher, I mean, like, everything had... you know, just such personality. Like, I've said before, Novigrad by itself could have been its own game.
Oh, yeah. That was a complete open world game 10 years ago.
In that city, yeah. Like, that city by itself, like, all of its side quests and plot points, that could have been, like, The Witcher 3 Part 1, and then they could have released, like, Part 2 later.
And how much they stuffed into that game, and I can't disagree with you. I mean, I think differently, but it's... You think about even just the, not only the exploration, but the world itself is very detailed, and there's so much to see, but
right.
Even when it comes to, oh, discovering the next thing, I give it to Zelda, but I think about The Witcher, and, you know, every time you play, it's different where things are, so discovering the new, like, building a sword or something, or
right.
Usually for me, it was the different potions, the different concoctions, and, making like the bombs and stuff.
Yeah, I love the different ways that you could engage with enemies. And you know, there was like the regular normal mode, which kind of gave you the freedom to choose. But then like in the harder difficulties of that game, you really had to, you know, get serious about like making concoctions and different, yeah, like more creative ways to engage the enemies.
Really having to pause and think about, which you still could. And if you were good, you still could take on enemies that were levels above you for sure.
Oh yeah.
But you had to be careful. You really had to play to your strengths and to their weaknesses.
Yep, absolutely.
And it was cool that, you know, finding stuff, like you could go through 3/4 of the game and finally get like find all the potions and all the upgrades for like Great Whale or something, let's say, and but you can never upgrade it because you didn't get like the second version of it, and 3/4 of the way through the game you finally find it just in some rut somewhere, and it's like,
yep.
Oh sweet, now I can upgrade this all the way. And I thought that was really cool, you know, that it's just, you think, okay, I found all these things and it makes me feel like a badass, but also like, what else am I missing? This world,
yeah,
is huge.
Oh yeah, it took me a good 2.5 playthroughs, I think, to collect all of like the little hidden details in that game.
Yeah.
And again, like, I feel like people hear criticism of Breath of the Wild and they automatically assume you're bashing it. But I really love that game. It's just I thought that there were other games that did what it did, just from my personal point of view, a little better.
Yeah. It's Breath of the Wild. It was surprising how big that world is. And not because, oh, it's a Zelda game, but it was like, the climbing mechanic, once you really like,
oh yeah,
kind of started maxing out your stamina and making that your own, it's like, oh, the world is also, not only is it humongous, like I can go to these towers that you see all the way across the world, but it's so vertical too. Like,
oh
I
yeah,
can be on top of this mountain, and then there's also like those huge valleys, and they stuff that those full of crap too. Like, they must have had a team of people working on every single region in that game,
yep.
And being like, just stuffed us to the brim, put 200 Korok seeds.
That's exactly right.
In every,
yeah,
place, put a whole bunch of treasure and just these enemy camps, and mm-hmm. It's nuts.
Yeah,
it's
and I really admired that. Even if I wasn't like super into the Korok seeds as collectibles, like I still admired the fact that you were basically on this constant treasure hunt. That was really cool.
Yeah. I like, it was like just enough that it's like, have I explored? Like, I've been here a million times, and of course there's a new Korok seed. It's like, wow.
mid ether. I'm not going to use my high ether. There we go.
This person's kind of a pushover too, huh?
Yeah, they're not bad. Uh-oh, confuse is not good though.
Yeah.
Oh, and he fell for it. Let's see here. I don't think Marley can cure status ailments, so I'm gotta use
Anastasia. Wait, didn't you learn haste? I missed that.
The last battle.
Sweet. Yeah, this is about the time I did it.
In fact, yeah, let's cast it on Marley so that she can get those heals out a little faster.
That's a good idea.
Because Chrono and Mog are already plenty fast.
Say Mog? Sweet.
Mog. Frog, yeah.
Poopo.
That would be an interesting... why can't I... Is someone silenced? Oh, there we go. No, never mind. Frog just wasn't there yet. Yeah, I seem to remember out of the two boss fights, Flea being more annoying with the status effects, but... overall, like, not as hard of a fight. Like, she doesn't have anything that, like, really devastates you. The way Slash can, like, with his attacks if you don't stay on top of your heels.
Yeah. Confuse is annoying.
Yeah, confuse is very annoying. Oh, and sleep is certainly annoying,
yeah,
too.
That's, yeah, not great either.
Okay.
Shut down your dual tech.
Yeah, she did. Like, she is not a fan of those dual techs. That'll fuck her up, though. God damn it. I'm not gonna use ice water on her. Let's just heal up here before Chrono wakes up.
Yeah, so what else? Is there anything else, like, really big coming out this year? Like, I'm thinking, and anything I'm interested in,
it's like there is. I'm just not recalling it. Like, there's a good season of games coming up, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, Spider-Man for sure. Like, that's the biggest one I can think of.
Yeah.
Aside from, like, Smash Brothers.
Well, and for me, like, I'm pretty much going to close out the year with Dragon Quest.
Yeah. And I got my backlog, you know, of course. I'm so behind. Like, Nier's... Well, you know what? I think I'm going to really attack that game now. Because I was working on it a lot with Wifey, and she's saying, you know what? Go ahead, finish
just
it.
Just finish it, yeah.
I think I'm going to start blasting through it now. So, I can probably get through that one, like, this weekend or something, and then, start working on, Persona, maybe.
Yeah, imagine that.
I am really interested to get that game going. Before I get spoiled. Ooh.
Yeah, that hurt bad. I'm gonna have to do an Aura World here.
Freaky. But, yeah, I imagine there's spoilers in that game, and I'm usually pretty good at avoiding that stuff. I don't want that to happen, so
yeah,
going on the game.
Yeah, the game has a really interesting plot. I enjoyed it once again from start to finish. So yeah, these status effects. I must have gotten her below like half HP because now the status effects are really piling on.
She's using that move.
Yeah, quite a bit.
Come on, Chrono.
She's basically getting, like, double attacks now. Maybe I was wrong. Maybe it's her that's the bigger pain in the ass.
Seems like it right now. What is Chrono blind, or what is that?
Yeah, but I don't think it matters when you do the double tech.
When the dual tech, yeah.
Damn. I need that Aura Whirl here. See, how much did that heal for Marley? Not quite enough. Let's do that. God damn it. Though if she's gonna confuse one character, I guess Marley's the best one.
Yeah, it is.
Cause she doesn't do as much damage as Chrono or Frog.
She's just
there we go. Oh, that wasn't a kill. I was thinking that would be a kill.
Susceptible to some shit.
I'm gonna give Frog his vision back so that he can attack while Chrono and Marley heal. Switch it up a little bit here.
So, Solo, you enjoyed it?
Yes, very much liked Solo. And I guess I'm a minority there, but...
Okay.
Like I said, I know that I'm definitely very easy to please with movies, apparently. But, I don't know, I thought it was a lot of fun. Like, it was a lot more fun than more recent Star Wars movies.
Okay. What did you, like, just general, if you had to, like, give it a number grade or something and compare it to Episode 8, is it better or worse?
I mean, it's almost like a different genre than Episode 8, if that makes any sense.
I
mean, like,
that's how I felt about Rogue One, you know, it was just so different from the mainline stories, you know.
Yeah, it was
so
more like action comedy than anything else. It was good.
I figured it would have a lot of like comedic elements to it. Just,
yeah,
you know, the people who are in it.
Right, and then all of my worries about the main actor who played Solo were totally unfounded. Like he really nailed it. I thought.
Good. Okay, I'm looking forward to that then, because that's pretty much my main concern with the movie is that they were just gonna fuck up the character of Solo, which again, I'm not saying he has to be exactly the same. That kind of wouldn't make
sense. And no, he's not. He's definitely like intentionally more rough around the edges. Like yeah. he doesn't have Harrison Ford's like confidence, which is cool. I mean, he kind of builds up to it. By the end of the movie, he's more of a snarky, smartass kind of Solo.
He has to build to something, right. Or else there's just, you know, there's nothing there.
Right.
You always want some character growth, even if it's a prequel.
Yeah. He's way more vulnerable than Harrison Ford's Solo. I want to go outside and use a shelter here, I think.
Good thing.
Yep.
See
not outside. Here. Just a quick break here. Alright, let's go get Ozzy.
Fucking coming for you, Ozzy.
But yeah, it was a really good story. And then Donald Glover, as I'm sure you've heard, is a definite highlight of that movie.
Yeah.
He does a great Lando.
That's what I've been looking forward to.
And like, his banter with Han is so hilarious. I mean, yeah. It's just spot on. Like, they basically... From the moment they meet, they're kind of like in an intentional contest to like screw each other over however they can. Oh no, if only I had a massive devastating area of effect spell.
Do you remember Mario RPG when you get to Bowser's Keep near the end of the game?
You know what's so weird is I was just thinking, side note before you make your point, I was just thinking about that game today and how that needs to be on our short list of
oh yeah,
games to play. But go ahead. What were you gonna say about Bowser's Keep?
Well, that one's on the SNES Classic, right?
Yes.
So we can do that on the Elgato for sure. That's no. This part just reminds me of I think it was some of the doors you could do is you would just go through waves of enemies. And
yeah.
20 minutes, but it was still fun.
Yeah. Good. There was really no part of that game that wasn't fun.
No, that's true.
Oh wow.
Oh, wow, whoops. Okay. They called your bluff on that.
They did. They were ready for that shit.
They knew that was happening. Annihilation Zone. That wasn't much of an annihilation.
Mild inconvenience zone.
Barely a devastation.
Though it was ballsy of them to use the spell effect from Ultima in FF6.
It's true. I feel like this game really borrowed a lot from FF6.
Oh yeah, at its heart, it's a reskinned FF6 engine for sure.
Which is like, what's wrong with that? I mean,
nothing.
The FF6 engine, especially because we didn't have 5. So as far as SquareSoft game, I mean, there's a lot that didn't come here. You know, a lot. Terranigma.
Yep.
We didn't get FF5. We didn't get. A lot like the freaking Live Alive and all that stuff. Bahamut.
Lagoon, yep.
Bahamut, yeah, Lagoon. So, yeah.
Treasures of the Rudeness. Yeah, Japan was really not too keen, or they definitely underestimated what American audiences could handle.
Seriously, speaking of the Treasure of the Rudeness game, I haven't even like YouTubed it or anything, so I don't even know how this game looks, how it plays, aside from what you've shown me.
It also kind of borrows from that FF6 style engine.
Yeah, it's like,
as far as its look.
Once they did that, I mean, that game... Well, again, going from, like, FF2 to FF3 American was, like, a huge leap.
Right.
So, yeah, what's wrong with that? These games look really good.
Yeah, they do. I love this engine. Nice. But yeah, they made so many great JRPGs during the SNES and PS1 era. I mean, and it's a shame we didn't get them all, but even the ones we did get were still awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Miss Rue.
Yeah, okay. You
that'll be going on, Marley.
I quit myself.
Hold still and don't do anything while my lone female character changes out of her clothes. Oh, this is great. Slash, flee! Pardon, Zazie. They cannot help you anymore. Flying tongue flicking... Ozzy's in a pickle!
He's in a pickle.
You fucking bet you are, Ozzy. Oh, this part.
Yeah. I don't really remember that.
Look at his stupid shit-eating grin.
I do remember this, though.
Oh, he got me. He got me pretty good there. Oh, I got the dark mail, though, for Chrono. Or possibly Frog. Whose defense do I want to be higher? That's a substantial boost. Yeah, I guess let's do Chrono for now, and we'll let Frog catch up later.
Dark Knight Chrono.
Right? Okay, we're gonna... There we go. Not bad, how's this? Boom.
Trying to crank Ozzy.
It's like so much work for him.
Impossible. Inconceivable.
Now, remind me, you didn't really play through Chrono Cross, right?
No.
Okay, so the boss fight with them in that game means nothing to you.
Well, you fight...
You fight Ozzy, Flea, and Slash in Chrono Cross.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
I do have to play
fucking beds.
I have to like play the game from start to finish.
This is one like of those I'm things gonna, like
I'm
one of these days.
This game. Right, it is. It's going on the very long list of games I need to play.
I was gonna say you're only 18 years late to the Chrono Cross party. But I feel like that was probably one of those games that had you not moved to Chicago, we probably would have played that together.
Oh yeah, I'm sure.
Much like Xenogears. Look at this poor loser. Oh. Yeah, someone's got
Why
no
did
friends.
Even try?
Hey, give me a potion, though. Poor. He's like, you know what? I'm not even going to. Oh, shit. I hate this room. I always forget where the. Yep.
Oh, that's right.
Fortunately,
There's
these
like
guys aren't.
20 of those freaking holes in there.
There are, yeah. And I'm probably going to hit the. The lion's share of them too, so maybe we'll beat Ozzy and call it an episode, because I think by the time we get to Magus we'll have gone well over an hour.
This place is long. It's a long
yeah, surprisingly so. Now if I had a strategy guide
and that was kind of like before the internet, yeah. You would get a strat. I never had a strategy guide for this game.
Yeah, the first time I ever remember using GameFAQs was for PS1 RPGs.
Yeah, me too.
And boy, did I use them for that.
Now, once GameFAQs came around, it was like, nah, I don't want to replay these games, you know. Especially because there was like things. Think of like FF8, you know, a game like that where you could miss things. Really big.
Yep.
Like cards and stuff like that. And not be able to get back to them for like most of the game, or if you could at all.
Right.
So, GameFAQs is pretty valuable for that.
There we go. Attaboy, Frog. Yeah, no, GameFAQs was back in the day quite useful. I feel like more modern games, with the exception of like some of like the really in-depth RPGs, like The Witcher 3, there's not much that you really need a strategy guide for these days, because all of your objectives are kind of laid out before you. They have like the quest system, which is pretty well used by a majority of open world games, where they kind of like give you the list and they show you where your objective is. I mean, if you're patient, you really don't need a strategy guide for too many modern games.
Yeah, not to beat these games, it's pretty much for if they do decide to put secrets in, but they don't want to lock those behind a strategy guide.
Right.
Usually, you know, they want you to...
They want to lock them behind DLC.
Yeah, that's true.
The only games that I really buy strategy guides anymore for are basically ones where I kind of want the whole, like, collector's edition. Like, I got the FF15 guide, for instance.
And that's the thing, is I think that's the route strategy guides are going, and that's probably smart.
Right.
Is they're working more with the developers and like, hey, can you help us make a strategy guide that really pays respect
right.
to your
like
game?
They'll include art books and other things like that, yeah. Or interviews with the director, and yeah. You're right, it's a good way to do it.
It's like, okay, let me just, if I need something, I will just go on the internet, you know, mm-hmm. and you're right, most games you don't need a strategy guide, so it's pretty much to honor the game itself, you know.
Right. Yeah, you really don't even need, like, Dude. Oh, for God's sake.
That motherfucker right in front of me.
Fat sack of shit. Yeah, you definitely don't need, like game facts anymore. You can just YouTube it and get your answers instantly.
Yeah, that's a lot quicker. I feel like you've avoided most of the holes in there. Good job.
Yeah, it was luck.
I feel like there's like 20 more in there, seriously.
Yeah, it's pretty liberal with the holes there.
It seems right for a your mom joke or something.
Right. Yeah, they go full porn star. Cool. Well, this would be a good place to use a shelter, since hopefully I won't be falling down a hole again. Really? That was ridiculous. There we are. All
right.
It wouldn't let me use it like one pixel down from where I was. Cool. But the nice thing about this is fighting these things, it's like free EXP. And a lot of it.
Save points or whatever these things are.
Yeah, the fake save points. Like, they, like, watch the end of this fight. They give you a good amount of EXP for fighting these things. Let's see here. Yeah, 432.
Oh, yeah.
Just for that weak-ass battle. I think... Oh, sweet, and I got heal. It's basically just meant to have you level up before the actual
boss fights. The Magus fight, you know, it's not horrible, but it's long.
Yeah, and you can go down if you're not paying attention.
That's true. I feel like at the end of the fight, he starts doing some crazy magic that'll kill you.
Yeah. He brings out the area of effect spells, which is not kind. Oh, shit. Combo counter! Oh, that's right, and then enemies start doing these stupid... Nice. Now he's weak against magical attacks. Well. Tight. Oh, son of a bitch. I really thought that was gonna kill him. There he goes. Huh, that was a decent amount of EXP too for shorter fight. Oh, I hate these things. I forgot about those. Damn it. Whoops. At this point in the dungeon, they're just fucking with you. There we go. So don't run into those blackheads.
Oh god, okay.
Yeah, I know. It's always a strategy. And then I think this guy goes solo again. Yep, so they're not bad. When they're by themselves, they're not bad. It's that stupid combo counter.
Oh, that Donkey Kong came in handy.
Right. Oh dude, a Donkey Kong game. That'd be fun. Son
Wait,
of
what?
A bitch.
Why?
Yeah, he trapped me. We'll just do some potion heals.
Yeah, I should really pick up DK Tropical Freeze, since I never did for the Wii U.
Oh, that's a great game.
Yeah, that's what I've heard. Like, one of the best platformers of the time.
Yeah, and like one, probably my second favorite Donkey Kong Country game behind the original.
Wow, that's high praise.
Yeah, I really, really enjoyed it.
All those, well, Donkey Kong Country 3, I never really played. And, you know, didn't.
Yeah, that was probably my least, like, the SNES ones. Like, as they went along, I liked them less and less, unfortunately. And it's not even that they were bad games; it's that. I feel like they never quite reached the heights that were done in the original. So,
yeah,
like,
I'd agree.
Two was great, but wasn't quite as good as one. And then three, from what I saw of it, was acceptable. But again, when you already had one and two, which were great games, I mean, they really didn't introduce anything new or exciting.
Yeah, that's my experience too.
Nice. Oh, they lived.
Not for
Not
long.
Not for long, no. Biatch? Dude, 12 TP, that's nice. How am I doing with my techs? Kronos should be getting ready to learn Lightning too. Yeah, 118. Yeah. Damn it. Frog is about to learn Aerial Strike.
Oh, and she's about to learn Ice 2.
Ice 2 is really good. If I could have that by the time I fight Magus.
And Fire 2. Like, all those are humongous upgrades.
Yeah.
Because they're all area attack, aren't they?
Yes. But again, once Magus joins, I mean, there's just... Like, most triple techs aren't as good as his, like, Dark Matter spell. And the best part about him is, if you get that golden stud, which is real easy to get, it's almost like he's casting for free. I mean, it's insane. He's only using, like, 5 MP to cast the most powerful spell in the game.
Yeah, I don't remember that. So, where do you get that?
Once you get the pendant to unlock the black boxes, you just pick it up in one of the domes in the future. And it's, like, right there.
Okay.
And so, yeah, pretty much right after you get him, you can immediately go there and have him cast ridiculous spells for next to nothing. Speed belt, tight.
Nice. Chrono?
Silver earring boost max HP. That is nice, but I think, yeah, let's max out Chrono's speed. We'll give Frog the for some reason I was thinking Ribbon does what it does in FF16.
Oh yeah, that'd be great.
Ooh, Frog's gotta have the Hero's Badge. I forgot all about that. Marlee, magic scarf. She doesn't really benefit too much from the HP. Yeah, I think Magic Scarf is the way to go for her for now, too. Cool. Well, that was nice. Now, is there a save point before Ozzy?
There should be. I think so. There should be. I have to get to go for more of this shit.
Yeah, right. There we go. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's a save point before Ozzy. Nice. Give me those level ups.
Yep.
Yeah, dude, this ice water spell is pretty broken for this point in the game.
It's pretty, yeah.
I mean, it doesn't cost very much either. And it wrecks their shit.
I feel like you can, yeah, you can get past these battles pretty well as long as you're using your ethers and your shelters.
Yeah, I was gonna say, God help you if you didn't stock up on items before you came in. There we go. But yeah, now that you talked about it, I'm kind of jonesing for some Mario. Just a 2,000 of those guys. Damn. I'm really jonesing for some Mario RPG.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I'd be down to play that with you.
But at the same time, I'm also still really craving Illusion of Gaia, too. I'd love to see you do a playthrough of that.
Yeah, we should do that next.
Yeah, I think that should be our next RPG.
We still got to do Metroid Fusion, but yeah, as far as next RPG, because it's been... No, another Metroid.
Yeah, that's nice. Frog can't equip that, can he? Yeah. No, that's females only.
Okay. Yeah. But, yeah, it's been many years since I played. Well, I mean, it's been years since I played this game too, and this has gotten me interested. I want to, you know, hear the music and do whatever. No, so.
And fortunately, for Illusion of Gaia, I will have my instruction manual handy. So.
Okay. Oh, you're. Oh, that's right. Nice. You picked
so,
up.
So you won't be missing any red gems on my mark.
Sweet. You picked up an in-the-box version, huh?
That I did. It is
That's
sexy.
Awesome. With its humongous, basically, strategy guide that comes with the game.
Yep. Oh, that's right. They just mentioned Magus summoning Lavos. That's the assumption that you're operating
under.
That's pretty much
why you're coming here is it's like he's the big bad who's summoning Lavos. He's right. Like the antagonist of this game right now.
Right. Oh, that's right. This isn't really a fight.
No, you just hit these cranes.
Yep. Where do you think you're aiming? This is such a Squaresoft, like, 90s battle.
It is.
Shit, I really didn't need to waste my items. That's okay. Miss me! Dude, if this guy has... If they ever do, like, a, like, voice-acted version of this game, if he is anything but Eric Cartman, I'm gonna be disappointed.
I don't know. I don't know if I trust, Square to do a remake of this game with voice acting.
No, in fact, like if they were to do like a 3D remake of it, it wouldn't be the same.
Yeah. Well, it's the Secret of Mana. I've actually watched a lot of that game be played, Secret of Mana.
Yeah.
And aside from, I do not like the 3D. I feel like if they like, this is a lot to ask, but if they drew it, like redrew the game or something, did some style like that, that'd be fine. You know, or if they some kind of drawing / cel shaded graphics.
Yeah.
You know, I know they're not gonna do like, you know, painstaking sprite work again. I get that, but it's how it looked, and especially with the character's mouth not moving at all, like it just looked bad. And
well, what do you say, Max? Do we take on Magus?
Sure, he's right here.
Let's do it. Play the hits, the movie. Here we go. Sorry, so I cut you off.
No, that's okay. What was I talking about? This part's pretty true. Oh, it's another.
Yeah, they give you a twofer here.
Movie.
It's pretty badass, too, because the animation on Magus is really tight. But yeah, I feel like the Steam version strikes a really nice balance. They made a couple of quality of life upgrades. They put parts of it in widescreen, which is really neat.
That is really nice.
They included the anime cutscenes. This is just one of those games that the image in my head, in my imagination, is so distinct that I really wouldn't want a full 3D version.
No, me either.
It would lose something.
Even kind of the washed out, like smooth graphics of this, I did not like at all.
That bothered the crap out of me when it first came out. Really, I'm so glad that they listened to the fans on this one.
Yeah. This is a pretty dramatic scene.
Yeah. Here we go. Magus, you son of a bitch. That frog of so many days ago.
So many days ago.
Yeah, see, they're really vague about how long ago that fight actually was. Yeah, see, you're right. There's this great character growth with Frog. Things I would have never obtained. So he actually is grateful to Magus for cursing him. Because it taught
I'm
him to man up a little.
Talking about like courage or something like that.
Yeah, well, and his friends and, you know, the guts to wield the Masamune and...
Yeah.
Oh, what's happening here?
Was that, what, the dialogue?
Yeah, the dialogue just got really, glitchy. Huh, that was weird. Nothing too big was lost, though. Okay, so let's see here.
Ugh, that's such a cool fight, damn it.
It really is.
Wow, that didn't hurt.
Okay, he absorbs everything except for lightning. So that means Chrono has to be one to attack him. Yeah.
How his stuff works.
Now, the only thing was, maybe I should have brought Luca, because if he does the fire, I'm pretty well screwed.
Do you have to attack him with it for him to change, though, or can you just kind of...
No, I think you can land physical attacks with no consequences, but if you want to do serious damage to him...
Oh, yeah.
And fortunately, I have heal now, which is really nice. Because Frog could act as my supplemental healer.
Yeah.
I'm really glad I learned that before this fight. Yeah, that's nice.
Oh, yeah, that is.
So now let's see. It says he absorbs everything but shadow, so let me test out my physical attack theory here.
Ugh.
Oh, okay, cool. Absorbs all but water.
That's how you get him to change, I guess.
Oh, man. He wrecks your shit, though, if you're not careful. The other great thing about heal is it only costs 2 MP. So there is no reason not to use it. Damn. He is just a powerhouse, though.
He is.
This battle is all just about survival and whittling away at him. You fucker.
He just bitch slaps.
Yeah, he just lets you have it. We're gonna be fine, though. Just gotta outlast him.
Okay, yeah, that is very helpful. That would have made this battle a lot harder if Frog didn't know here.
Yep. In fact, every time I attack Magus, I'm just gonna have Frog ready with heal. Yeah, keep that coming. As long as he keeps doing this and letting Chrono, you know, wreck him with lightning, that's good.
Yeah, you're in good shape.
But there's like this countdown part of the battle where he gets ready to cast like his
Grand Train or whatever it
is. Yeah, Dark Matter.
Yeah, that part's hard. Because I remember that actually hurts quite a bit. Like, it'll kill you. It'll kill everyone. You're not careful.
Yeah.
I've definitely lost this fight before.
Yeah, I mean, if you're not patient, it's easy to lose. Ah, okay. Yeah, absorbs all but fire. So this is where Luca would be handy.
And you can force him to change if you...
Yeah, if you attack him, it forces him to change. Oh, shit.
Oh, who knows Shadow?
Yeah, no one has Shadow at this point. Though, technically some of Robo's attacks are Shadow Elemental, even though he doesn't know magic.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
And actually, you never... that was invisible in the Super Nintendo, but they show it to you in the DS version.
I'm actually like, I wouldn't know from any version just because I never use Robo.
Yes.
He just stays at the end of time. Forever.
Yep. Ooh, shit, I should have healed first and then cast. I'm about to get wrecked. Whoops. It's okay, we can recover from that.
Living dangerously.
A little bit.
The fucking sap move.
Yeah, I know, right?
It's just like constantly forcing me to heal.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really missing the music right now.
Yeah, I know. This is a really great track battle. It is. Yeah, this part really just forces you to wait him out.
Yep.
Oh. Oh, shit.
Oh, this is it, isn't it?
Oh, this is it. Okay, so let's see here.
Yeah, you can shoot it.
Lowers his guard.
I don't think he's gonna do anything else, though. Until he casts it, so as long as I think Frog gets one cure in, you should be okay.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Because there is no defend option in this game, you just have to pummel him.
You gotta be prepared. Okay, I think you should. You're probably already fine, but this is good, because he's gonna...
Yeah, better safe than sorry.
Adjust his little work gloves.
Yeah, cool? Right? Oh, Ice Sword is actually more potent than X-Strike. Good to know. Oh, shit.
Yeah, this is it.
That's the Lavos killer right there. Just do a double heal and cut my losses here. He didn't list an elemental weakness, did he? Shit, he's doing it again. That son of a bitch.
Now maybe you can finish him off this time.
Yeah, I think this should take him out. Especially if Frog lands a critical hit or two. There it is.
Ooh.
Tight.
Nope. Still sitting there mocking you.
Yeah, I know, right, man? He is fucking durable. Gotta hand it to him. He is not about to go down easily to a chump like me. God damn.
Oh, damn it. I thought that was it.
All right, we're just going to do the same damn thing. Whew. God.
Yeah.
God help you if you're not ready for that.
Seriously. That'll kill everyone.
Everything you love. Gone.
This
is the rest of the battle, yeah.
Do we go to Zeal after this, or do we,
No, you go back to Ayla's time.
That's right. Oh,
and then the Kingdom of Zeal.
Happens.
Yeah. Yeah, like, the story is just an avalanche after this part.
Yeah.
Like, you are constantly on the move to, like, a next major plot point. Like, the introductory phase is over. Oh, here we go. Speaking of major plot points, I wonder. Now, here's where it gets really complicated, too, because you figure out that Magus didn't actually create him.
Yeah. To figure out, yeah. It's like, wait a second.
And that he actually wants him dead.
Sorry, bro.
Oh, wait, no, you don't figure out that Magus wants to kill Lavos until the Kingdom of Zeal.
I think until you fight him again, or...
Yeah. Because when he finds himself in... finds himself in Zeal, he starts, like, calling himself a prophet and kind of manipulating the situation
to
get the Queen to summon Lavos.
To summon him, yeah.
And that was when he planned to kill him. Or it. Grano? Are you still blah, 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 blah? Oh, that's right. He has this weird dream where they're married. Yeah, the text is doing that weird thing again. Weird. I mean, it's not so bad, but...
Is it just...
You need to hold down a job.
Hold down a job.
Yeah. Oh, no. Crono. Kron. Oh, Crono. I wonder what's causing that. I mean, it's not, like I said, it's not too big of a deal. I know the story of this game inside and out. But I can see that being annoying for people who are, like, are actually following the story of the... Like you said, I feel bad for the person who, who this is their first exposure to Crono Trigger.
Yeah.
Ayla Carrier back hut. Magus!
I like that image of Crono, though. You save the world, and then he becomes like a, just a jobless sack.
Yeah, right? He's just a loser after this whole
belly.
Thing's over.
Just...
So he has fled. That horse's ass!
Just becomes like the town idiot and drunk. Like,
yeah, right. I was a great hero once.
Traveled back in time and saved the whole goddamn world. It's like, ooh.
He's still wearing
Stay away from that man.
He's still wearing his Letterman jacket to formal dinners.
He's that guy.
Yeah, right. Oh, it was a big fucking deal. Remember that game senior year when I caught that interception? Come on, Crono. That was 20 years ago. Fuck you, Frog. You weren't even there. Little arts and crafts bitch frog. Okay. And that's a good place to call it. Drunken jock chrono. All right, buddy. Well, this was a really productive episode. This, it was a longer one for sure. But
I didn't think we would get all through the Magus's castle.
Yeah, I have a feeling that we'll probably have a couple of longer episodes of this game just because I can't put it down once I get going. But
Yeah. Like you said, this is when it really starts rolling here.
Yep. But hey, them's the kicks. So YouTube, we will see you next time on Chrono Trigger.
Later.